In today's video, I'm going to show you a handful of lanyard knots. And lanyard knots are used for lanyards, obviously, and commonly, if you have something like a knife like this, which has a little lanyard tube on, what people do like to do sometimes is pass something, obviously a piece of cord or something, through that lanyard hole, like so. And then you can tie a knot on the string there, and that creates a lanyard for your knife, which makes it easy to get out of your pocket. In terms of leatherwork, because obviously this is a leatherwork channel, where this is sometimes used is for drawstrings or close your strings on items. So for example, if I've got a pouch here, then I have a little cord lock on the back for the cord, which comes open, and then the pouch can open, and so that cord lock doesn't come flying off that cord, we have a knot on the cord. So whether you would be watching this video as a leather worker wanting to, you know, think about how to enhance your leather items, or whether you're just watching it simply for the knots because you want to tie something like a lanyard on a knife, then it's the same knot either way. So this first knot will be a two-strand Matthew Walker knot, and all these knots will be two-strand knots. So in other words, we're working with two loose ends of cord like this. And this one's nice and easy. So we take the ends of the cord, take the right-hand side, bend it down against itself, take the left-hand side and bend it down against itself. So we end up with two loops like this. And take the right-hand loop, I'm going to pass it behind those two central threads, like so. Take the left-hand loop, pass it in front of those two central threads. So everything we're doing here is opposites. We're going to take this loose end of thread here that's at the front. We're going to pass it down through that right-hand loop. Then we're going to do the opposite thing. So we're going to take the one that's at the back and bring it up through the left-hand loop. And then we're going to repeat that process. So again, we're going to take this one that's at the back. We're going to bring it round and up through the left hand side, and then the one that's at the front is going to go round and down through the right hand side. So these are wrapping around that central bit of thread, and then once we've done that, we should have two ends here. We can then pull that up tight, and what we're going to get is a kind of a little cross shape. So the second knot is a two-strand stopper knot, and this is a little bit more complicated. So we'll put the blue one down a second. First thing I'm going to do, I'm going to take the red thread and I'm going to form a loop. So I'm going to bend it back on itself and make a little loop. And I'm then going to weave this blue one around here a little bit. So I'm going to come up through the loop from the back side, and then going to go behind this loose end. I'm going to go in front of this end here. I'm going to come back, and from the underneath, I'm going to come through the loop and then in front of its own thread. So we've weaved it around. The next thing we're going to do is going to exit both of these threads through this central hole. So where we've got the kind of middle of the knot there, that's where we want the ends to both come out of that hole so that it looks neat when it pulls tight. So we take this blue end, we go behind everything and come up through that hole. We take the red end, we go in front of everything and come up through that hole. So we're exiting in the same place. And then again, we can snug this knot tight. The final knot that we're going to do is what's known as a diamond knot, and these are really, really popular for doing things like lanyards on little knives. It does create a really nice look, so for whatever application you want these for, this is one of the nicest ones to do. So I'm going to twist it round this way so that the thread passes underneath itself. And then I'm going to weave this around in the same way as the carrick bend. So the easiest way to do this, if you're tying it in your hands, is to take this loose end, pass it behind everything like so, and then pull it back like that, so that you pull this piece here through to the back of the loop so that you can see where you need to go over and under. The piece that's loose then here, pass it over, down through the loop, underneath itself, and back out of the loop. So we've created that same shape there that you get with the Carrick. And at this point I can actually take my hands off that so you can see the shape as well, because it'll hold itself there. So similar to the second knot, we want these loose ends to then exit the middle of the knot. So here where we've got a diamond shape in the middle of the knot, that's where we want the ends to come through. So from here, I'm going to take the red end, I'm going to go over the blue here, around to the back, and then up through that central hole, like so. And then the same with the blue, it's going to go over the red thread here, around to the back, and then up through that central hole. And then we can pinch these two, and that's the knot. And then again, we need to work the knot tight. And with the more complex knots like this, that takes a little bit more to-ing and fro-ing, because if you just pull it tight, as you can see, it doesn't come where it should do. So what you have to do is you have to work all the slack through the knot, but it'll try and tighten itself. So what you need to do is kind of pull all the little loose bits until you keep getting slack on the ends. It's just a matter of working all the slack out of the knot. And every time you get a little bit, just a bit like that, that you can then pull through like that. Look, you work it a little bit tighter. And that's the same knot that you can see, except this is done using leather belting rather than paracord, which obviously you can use on these kinds of items as well. This is round leather belting, but that's the same exact knot there, the diamond knot. So the final thing to do is to just tidy up these ends. Now, the neatest way to do this, if you're doing any volume of them, is with a hot knife, which I will show you. You can just cut it with some side cutters, melt it with a lighter, and squidge it in your fingers. That works fine. So I'll just show you that with a scrap piece here. So if I was to cut it off, the side cutters will do a reasonably neat job, or you can use a knife. You can melt the end, and then you can just squish it with your fingers to seal it like so. That's okay, but you will quickly get tired of, you know, kind of slightly burning the end of your fingers and messing about with that. So I actually use one of these Dremel hot tools for doing this. It's a butane powered thing, so you put gas in it like you would with a refillable light. It's actually just the same as this inside, and then it comes with various tips, and all it does essentially is heat the tip. And you get 5 or 6 different tips for different things with it. I'll put a link to this down in the video description in case you're interested in it. The only tip that I really tend to use with it is the hot knife tip. You can also do pyrography, soldering, and things like that. I don't normally do this inside either, because it does create a bit of a smell. But since we're filming, I'll do these ones. So all you do with this, once you've got the gas in, is you flick the safety up, pull it down. It makes a really weird noise, which will scare you the first time you do it, and you're gripping it in your hand. So once you've got the gas going, you flick the lock on, and then you can let go of the switch, and that's now heating up. And obviously you need to be extremely careful with these, because they do get, obviously, you know, super hot on the end, and you don't want to burn yourself. So just put it to one side and let that heat up for a second. So once that's hot enough to work, it will essentially cut and seal the thread in one go. It's a little bit like cauterizing a wound or something. So I can simply trim these off. Now, I don't trim them right next to the knot, because you don't want the knot coming under, and also it looks a bit naff. So I always leave sort of about, I don't know, half an inch or something like that. And you can then simply cut through like so. And now it's going to smell in here. Once you've done with this, you flick the lock off, and that turns it off. So if you can see the ends of those thread there, they're nice and neatly cut, they're all square, and they're all melted and sealed, which means the inside bits aren't trying to come out. There's a couple of books by J.D. Lenzen, specifically about paracord, tying things with paracord. There's two volumes of these now. These are really good books, and they'll show you how to do all these kind of things. That diamond knot that I've shown you is in there. All these kind of things that you can see in the background on the cover. So I'll put some links into those. And then if you're interested in knots in general, obviously there's loads of books on knots. The absolute Bible, if you want to treat yourself to it, is this. Which is known as the Ashley Book of Knots, or it's often abbreviated just ABOK. So if you're looking on any websites or anything about knots, and it says things like, it looks like it says ABOK 123, it's actually referring to the 123rd knot in this book. This is an absolutely, look, you see how thick it is. This is an absolutely immense book, and it's probably got every knot that you can imagine in there. But if you're interested in the craft side of it, there's all history and instructions and everything in there. So I'll put a link into this as well, just in case you want to look at it. Okay, so I hope you found that useful. You can refer back to this whenever you like, if you're wanting to, as I say, tie some little, you know, knife type lanyards, knots, or whether you're working on a leather item like this, or you're doing a sheath that ties to your leg or anything like that, where you want to do a little fancy knot. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.